This short presentation introduces the concept of capital management in banks using components of the corresponding module found under Optimal MRM's e-learning service. The asset portion of the balance sheet represents the bank's investments in assets financed with a combination of debt and equity. There are constraints on the structure of the balance sheet in large deposit-taking commercial banks. Such banks operate with a natural allocation to what can be referred to as structural assets. The equity portion of a bank's balance sheet is sometimes referred to as bank capital. More accurately, bank capital is a disproportionate sum of debt and equity capital. It is incumbent on a bank to strategically optimize the allocation of its capital within structural constraints in order to maximize its return on equity and return on capital. Economic capital is the amount of capital that a bank needs to cover the risk of insolvency from unexpected losses. Regulatory capital is the amount of capital required by regulation. Bank shareholders and rating agencies generally demand a higher amount of capital than regulation. Whereas economic capital and regulatory capital are conceptually similar in a number of ways, an important difference is that economic capital is calculated using a bank's internal risk analysis and capital definition. Regulatory capital is calculated using models that are prescribed by regulators. Due to the risks that banks are deemed to pose to local and global economies, they are subject to domestic and international regulations. Restrictions are imposed on the maximum amount of leverage that banks can apply to the balance sheet. Leverage can be expressed in a number of ways. A common general definition is the ratio of assets to capital. In more familiar terminology, banks are subjected to capital adequacy requirements. The second iteration of Basel, published in 2004, is composed of three pillars and goes into extensive detail on the measurement of risk-weighted assets and capital ratios. Prior to 2007, regulatory capital associated with trading risk exposure was tied primarily to a bank's simple VaR measure. Regulators came to view VaR in isolation as an unreliable measure to use as a basis for setting capital requirements. They sought to correct this weakness by introducing a new set of requirements under a precursor to Basel III, known as Basel 2.5. The intent of these additional exposure measurement requirements is to increase the level of RWA, which in turn increases the amount of minimum capital that banks are required to hold. Regulatory capital is composed of two tiers of capital. Common equity and retained earnings are referred to as core capital, or Common Equity Tier 1, or CET1. Other Tier 1 capital is referred to as non-core T1 capital, or additional Tier 1 capital. Tier 2 capital is referred to as supplementary capital. The sum of Tier 1 and Tier 2 capital is referred to as the bank's total capital base. Capital ratios are calculated by subtracting from this base, in whole or in part, items such as goodwill, other intangible assets, and deferred assets, and dividing by the sum of risk-weighted assets. Under Basel II, banks are required to hold a minimum total capital ratio of 8% of their RWA, of which Tier 1 capital is at minimum 4%, and core or CET1 capital is at minimum 2%. Leverage can be expressed in terms of the ratio of assets to capital. Leverage is defined in Basel III as the ratio of total capital to assets. The inverse of this ratio is the assets to capital multiple. Basel's 3% minimum leverage ratio means that the size of a bank's assets cannot be more than 33 times its capital. A key bank objective is to maximize its return on equity, or broadly speaking, return on capital. It must do so within constraints imposed by regulators, shareholders, and other constituents. Inasmuch as leverage presents banks with opportunities to generate higher returns on capital, it also carries risks. The bank's return on equity increases as the size of the loan book grows. Funding growth purely with deposits, however, rapidly decreases capital ratios and increases balance sheet leverage, or in Basel III terms, reduces the bank's leverage ratio. Adverse scenarios include a general loss of confidence in the banking system. This can manifest as a rapid withdrawal of deposits. Such a scenario would force a bank to either sell assets in a forced liquidation manner or to replenish capital with debt such as additional bond issuance or with equity such as additional common share issuance. In 2008, the deflation of the housing bubble globally drove many borrowers into bankruptcy. This put downward pressure on the value of banks' loan assets and in turn eroded capital. As a result, many banks were at risk of insolvency had they not been supported with capital from central banks and national treasuries. Optimal MRM invites you to visit its store online to learn more about this and other available market risk e-learning modules.